to our service this evening. Welcome to those of us gathered here in the building and those who will be watching along online. It's lovely to gather together here. A moment of quiet before we begin. And opening our service booklets and turning to page 3. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, for 40 days we have been celebrating with joyful hearts the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, his bursting from the tomb, and his defeat of the power of sin and death. He appeared to his disciples many times and told them about the kingdom of God. Today, we recall how he left this earth and returned to his Father, ascending into heaven to take his throne over all dominions and powers. As we participate in this service, we are invited to trust in his reign over all creation and to submit to his kingly yet loving rule. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen. And to the confession on page 4. Seeing we have a great high priest who has passed into the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us draw near with a true heart, in full assurance of faith, and make our confession to our heavenly Father, saying together, Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you.
Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive you your sins, open your eyes to God's truth, strengthen you to do God's will, and give you the joy of his kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
We come now to a time of quiet prayer. Let us pray. Pray together. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that as we believe your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to have ascended into the heavens, so we in heart and mind may also ascend and with him continually dwell, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now. We have our first reading.
Reading is from Ephesians chapter 4, verses 1 to 13. I, Paul, the prisoner in the Lord, implore you therefore to lead a life worthy of your vocation, gentleness, and patience. Do all you can to preserve the unity of the Spirit by the peace that binds you together. There is one body, one Spirit, just as you were all called into one, and the same hope when you were called. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God who is Father over all, through all and within all. Each one of us, however, has been given his or her own share of grace, given as Christ allotted it. The one who rose higher than all the heavens to fill all things is none other than the one who descended. And to some his gift was that they should be apostles, to some prophets, to some evangelists, to some pastors and teachers, so that the saints together make a unity in the work of service, building up the body of Christ. In this way, we are all to come to unity in our faith and to our knowledge of the Son of God, until we become a perfect person, fully mature with the fullness of Christ himself.
As we reflect on those words, perhaps we could read the bottom reflection as we listen together to the hymn, Jesus is King, declaring again that sense of Jesus ascending to heaven and taking up his rightful place in the kingdom. We actually come now to our gospel reading, which is also in the prayer.
Alleluia, alleluia. Go and make disciples of all nations, says the Lord. Remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Jesus showed himself to the 11 and said to them, go out to the whole world. Proclaim the good news to all creation. The one who believes and is baptized will be saved. The one who does not believe will be condemned. These are the signs that will be associated with believers. In my name, they will cast out devils. They will have the gift of tongues. They will pick up snakes in their hands and be unharmed should they drink deadly poison. They will lay their hands on the sick, who will recover. And so the Lord Jesus, after he had spoken to them, was taken up into heaven. There, at the right hand of God, he took his place, while they, going out, preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word by the signs that accompanied it. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
Lord, we ask for your continued presence amongst us, that we may learn, that we may receive, that we may respond. In your precious name we pray. Amen. What difference does it make? I suspect if we were asked that question about Christmas, what difference does it make? We could come out with some kind of answer. And the same, I should think, about Good Friday or Easter. But I wonder how we'd get on if we were asked out of the blue about the ascension of Jesus. What difference does it make? It may be that one of the words from one of the hymns that Angela was playing before the service would come to mind. It might be something like the ascension window behind me would come to mind. But I'm not sure still that that would solve the sort of mind block. What difference does it make in daily life? As an aside, I think some of you may have heard this story from me before. I was curate at a parish with an ascension window, and the school used to come in for an Ascension Day service. And the then rector was saying to the children, well, you know, the window behind me really shows what happened. What he didn't realise was that there was some work being done, and at the same time that he was saying that, you could see the silhouette of a man climbing a ladder. So I'm not quite sure what the children went away with from that service, so beware preacher, I think. But there is one hymn that has a wealth of insight, I think, to answer that question. And quite often it is words from hymns that come to mind. So if you'd like to turn to page 15 of the service booklet, I think that's the right page, page 15, you'll find one hymn there. And we're going to hear it later and say some of the words later. Verse 1, if you look at it, has a wealth of praise response. It sets the scene, it reminds us of the ascension, and invites us to respond with praise. Jesus is King, and I will extol him, give him the glory and honour his name. And then this reminder, he reigns on high, enthroned in the heavens. Word of the Father, that takes us back to Jesus, the Word amongst us, the Word made flesh, Word of the Father, exalted for us. And then verse 2, we have a hope that is steadfast and certain. We know that Jesus is alive forevermore. Our knowledge of that is steadfast and certain. Gone through the curtain and touching the throne, the curtain there, the divide between heaven and earth, between sacred and secular, between basically us and God. That curtain was broken from heaven's side by the incarnation, the birth of Jesus, and it was broken again from earth's side by the ascension. And the tearing of the curtain in the temple as Jesus died was another sign of this. So Jesus has gone through the curtain and is touching the throne, is there with God the Father. And then those two next lines in that verse, wonderful words, I think. We have a priest who is there interceding. That picks up a lot of what we can read in the letter to the Hebrews. Jesus is our great high priest, and he is there interceding for us. And just as we ask one another for prayer, so we can ask Jesus to pray. He's always there interceding for us. And then pouring his grace on our lives day by day. Wow, what a difference the ascension makes with that understanding. How about starting each day with this awareness? Jesus is only praying for you, but he wants to pour out his grace upon you day by day. And verse 3 then can embody our response to that. We come to him, our priest and apostle, clothed in his glory and bearing his name. We rely on him. It's not that we are worthy, but he is. And then laying our lives with gladness before him. That could be the third line of our opening prayer to each day. Laying our lives with gladness before him. And then we sort of preempt Pentecost, filled with his spirit. We worship the King. And each of us is already given the Holy Spirit. And then verse 4 returns us to praise. If we've read the end of Luke's Gospel tonight, praise was the very first response of the first disciples to the ascension of Jesus. They went back to Jerusalem and were praising God. And that verse 4, O Holy One, our hearts do adore you, thrilled with your goodness, we give you our praise. Angels in light with worship surround him. Jesus, our Saviour, forever the same. So I'd invite you to read through that hymn again slowly now. And see which lines stand out for you. It's obvious which lines stand out for me from what I've said. It may be something different for you. So just a few moments to read through that and see what God is saying or how you want to respond to God. Let's say verses 2 and 3 together. We have a hope that is steadfast and certain, gone through the curtain and touching the throne. We have a priest who is there interceding, pouring his grace on our lives day by day. We come to him, our priest and apostle, clothed in his glory, and bearing his name, laying our lives with gladness before him, filled with his spirit, we worship the King. Amen.
And remembering that hope that is steadfast, let us stand together and declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Do stand if you're able as you read the words on page 7.
seeking the Father's blessing and the gifts of the Spirit. Jesus Christ, great High Priest, living forever to intercede for us, pray for the Church, your broken body in the world. Lord, hear us. Jesus Christ, King of righteousness, enthroned at the right hand of the Majesty on high, pray for the world and make it subject to your gentle rule. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, Son of Man, drawing humanity into the life of God. Pray for your brothers and sisters in need, distress, or sorrow. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, pioneer of our salvation, bringing us to glory through your death and resurrection. Surround with your saints and angels those who have died trusting your promises. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, Lord over all things, ascended far above the heavens and filling the universe. Pray for us who receive the gifts you give us for work in your service. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, keep the Church in the unity of the Spirit and in the bond of peace, and bring the whole created order to worship at your feet. For you are alive and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
If you are able, will you please stand as we come to the time of sharing peace together. Because of the current restrictions, we're not able to share peace with one another in a physical way through a handshake or a hug or anything like that, but we still can share peace with one another by waving, by offering peace to them. And so, as we come to sharing peace, do offer it in that socially distanced way. Jesus says, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. If you love me, rejoice because I am going to my Father. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you." Let us offer one another that sign of God's peace. So we're going to take a moment to reflect again on those words as we listen together to that great word on page 15.
Thank you.
blessed be God, by whose creation is renewed, by whose love heaven is opened, by whose mercy we offer our sacrifice of praise. Blessed be God forever. And as we come to the Eucharistic prayer, you'll find in the middle of page 10 what would normally be a song, Holy, Holy, Holy. So what we're going to do is say the first two lines of each of those verses as we're not able to sing tonight. So when we get to there, the first two lines of each verse. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and good, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, the King of glory. Born of a woman, he came to the rescue of our human race. Dying for us, he trampled death and conquered sin. By the glory of his resurrection, he opened the way to life eternal. And by his ascension, gave us the sure hope that where he is, we may also be. Therefore, the universe resounds with Easter joy, and with choirs of angels, we sing forever to your praise. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Holy is the Lord God Almighty. Blessed, blessed, blessed be the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the Lord's name. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Jesus Christ is Lord. Lord, I am cross and resurrection. You have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with St. Alkmund and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, for ever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. King. individual words of administration, but those that I'll say in a moment are for us all. And so the bottom of page 12. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. And so may the body and blood of Christ, given for us in such a love, keep us all in eternal life. We continue with the reading on page 13.
Then the disciples returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet,
say the responses together at the bottom of page 13. As we wait in silence, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we listen to your word, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we worship you in majesty, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your refreshing, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your renewing, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your equipping, make us ready for your coming, Spirit. As we long for your empowering, make us ready for your coming, Spirit.
And so may Christ, our ascended King, pour upon you the abundance of his gifts and bring you to reign with him in glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. And a final hymn to listen to return to praise, and to be energized by God. We have the hymn, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. you go, if you would please remember not to chat within church, but to move outside. And if you would take